want to make sure that everybody is protected in Biafra land. Stay away from arms way. The Liberation Army will be out to protect you, defend you, and make sure that you are not harmed. You are not going to be left just like that. No, you don't be left alone. But what we are begging is that you should be away from arms way. Allow the Liberation Army to defend you and protect you. Allow them to do their job. The dates have been given from 23 to 28. Just be in your home, enjoy your food with your family, continue to pray for Biafra within that period. If you can fast, fast. If you cannot fast, eat with your family, stay in your family, discuss and teach your children one thing or the other. Learn the national anthem and the pledge of Biafra within that period. Because we are going home. There's no two ways about it. Everything we are saying today is to get you, put you in line, to make sure you don't get distracted, to make sure you don't get deceived. Because for going home, we will definitely, definitely go home. No man born of a woman can stop that. It is written. We are going home. It doesn't matter whether you agree or you don't agree. It doesn't matter whether you believe it or you don't believe it. It doesn't matter whether you contribute to it or you don't contribute to it. What matters today is that it is going to happen. And you must pay attention so that you don't put yourself in harm's way. What matters to us today is to make sure that every single soul in Biafra land is protected, including our visitors, including our friends. Everybody has to be protected. That is why we continue to make the announcement. If you have not heard, hear it now. If you have heard, tell your neighbor, tell your friends. Those who are going to be traveling to the Biafra land within that period, be very careful. There's no point traveling to that Biafra land that period. Wherever you are, stay there until this very date is gone. Stay wherever you are. Stay wherever you are. The announcement has been made for a very long time. We have been calling people for a very long time to mind where they are. Some who are very far away in the north to come back to southeast or south-south or wherever they are, they come back to the south. If you're in the far north, come back to the south. The announcement has been made more than, for a very, very long time. And Mazin Nani kind of made it clear at that time that no matter where you choose to be, you cannot stop us from fighting for freedom. We cannot stop asking for our freedom simply because you are trying to protect one room hotel that you have somewhere. You want to protect the business you have somewhere. Because of that, you allow the innocent people to begin to sacrifice their life on a daily basis. We can't continue on that very path. We want to make sure that everybody is liberated and everybody will have an equal right to exist and survive in a sane environment. The struggle we are in today, it is not just to liberate the African people. It is to liberate everybody, to make sure that every indigenous tribe in Biafra land is liberated. We all need that freedom because every indigenous tribe, we have all suffered a lot in the hand of this zoological republic. They have given us a bad name. They have restructured, they have structured our mind to be dubious and fraudulent. That is why today, you see people, once you go out of the country and people identify you as a Nigerian, they begin to get scared of you. Once people know that you are a Nigerian, they begin to look at you twice. All thanks to the contraption called Nigeria. Because the country has made its own people to become fraudulent in nature. The name itself is a fraud. The name itself is a fraud. That is why whenever you mention it, people look at you twice. When you go to pursue any business abroad with that name, you will fail. Because even the leadership of the country, the presidency itself, they are corrupt and fraudulent. You see how low they could go to go and forge a letter. Forge a letter to show the world that Mazi Simon Ekpa was banned by Finland government not to broadcast. This is how loaded, and you can't believe the amount of forgery they have been making. There are so many lies they have told about Biafra for a very long time. So many lies just to paint Biafra's evil. But I thank you that today our spokesperson, Master Simon Ekpa, has been able to use the autopiloted movement to turn this around. And he was able to drag an international correspondent to come down to Biafra land and interview people by themselves. Why they were busy gossiping, why they were busy calling names, why they were busy writing petition. We were busy doing our own duty on the ground. Our spokesperson, Master Simon Eka, was busy with the autopiloted group doing the needful on the ground, creating awareness, dragging the international media, journalists into Biafra land to go to the ground and see what we are saying, that we are not just noisemakers online. They call us miscreants. They call us noisemakers. They call us all kinds of names, thinking that they're going to distract us with that. But I thank Chukwuka Abiamah that they gave us that mental toughness to endure in the midst of all the insult and abuse. We stood our ground. We continue to preach the gospel. We continue to speak to the people. We continue to say our mind. We continue to create awareness. And today, I can tell you, the awareness has been created and more voices are listening. And in days to come, more international media will come online. Already, they are applying. Many international media are already reaching out to our spokesman, Master Simon Eka, for an interview. Just recently, he granted an interview to Arise TV. Just recently, he granted an interview to the branch of Arise TV. But you know Arise TV because they are in Nigeria. Because they are in Nigeria, there are certain things they will still go to censor so many things. They will censor so many things. They will first of all go edit, re-edit and edit before they present his response. But as time goes on, I tell you, more truths are coming out. At least if you can be able to gag your local media and direct them and tell them what to show and what not to show, what to broadcast and what not to broadcast. But you can't do that in international media. Very soon, the CNN and the BBC will beg for interview from our spokesperson. They will beg for interview. The battle we are fighting is a just one. A just battle, that is what we are fighting. We are fighting for a just cause. We are not fighting out of wickedness, out of pride, out of envy, out of jealousy. No, we are fighting to preserve life of the indigenous people in that contraption called Nigeria. We are fighting to save life because of the evil that we have seen that is coming. Our Supreme Amazon Nandi can warn them about what is happening today. He warned. He cried out and he warned about what is happening today. And nobody paid attention. They called him a noisemaker. They took his word for joke. They took it for a bluff. And today, look at how the whole place is. Has Nigeria not become worse than Somalia? Has it not become worse than Somalia? And before your own very eyes, foreigners are coming in to take over your land. The government condones, they are not doing anything. The government by themselves come out and tell you that foreigners are around, armed to the teeth to take over your land. What the government will tell you is to accommodate them, accept them, bring them close. You don't have to send them out. That is what we hear from the government. That foreigners are coming in to take over your land. You tell us to accommodate them. The military are supposed to pursue and prepare and protect the territorial boundaries of the country. The military that are supposed to protect the territorial boundaries of the country, they are not protecting. What they are doing is they go after the civilians to open fire. They go after the civilians that are exercising their freedom of speech. They go after the civilians that are demanding for their legitimate right of self-determination. They go after the innocent citizens that are laying one complaint or the other about the situation of things instead of paying attention or listening to them. They go after them. And every time we continue to hear about death upon death, every day people are dying in the Biafra land. If you are not being shot by the police, you'll be shot by the military. You'll not be shot by the military. You'll be shot by the terrorists. You're not shot by terrorists. The herdsmen will kidnap you. If you're not kidnapped by herdsmen, the death squad we kidnap you. If you're not kidnapped by them, the unknown gunman, which is sponsored by the government, will come after you. All this we are created to make sure that we don't have a say, to make sure we're not protected. Meanwhile, they will turn around and tell us the primary purpose of the government is to protect the people, their life and their property. That the primary objective of the government is to protect the life and property of their citizens. For the fact that they're not ready to protect the Biafran people, it shows that we are not citizens of that very contraption. That is what it shows. So when you see a Biafran asking for his own nation, he has every right to ask for such. He has every legitimate right to demand for his own country where he's being protected. Because in the business of Nigeria, they are not accommodated. They are not protected. They are not safe. They destroy their property, destroy their businesses, take their life. And you want them to fold the hand and continue to watch. God forbid. It is because of this dehumanization of the Biafran people. That is why today Biafrans have risen up. They have taken their fate into their own hand. After crying for a very long time, after sharing tears for a very long time, complaining for a very long time, complaining to almost all the government of the world, nobody is paying attention. We have come back to the drawing board to take our freedom by ourselves, because freedom is not given, it is taken. We waited for a very long time. And finally, here are we today, counting days. And you think you can bully us into submission? You're wasting your time. There is no amount of bully that will make us stop demanding for that which is ours. It is a decision that we have already reached. And we are going to stand on that decision. No matter what anybody says, no matter what anybody does, we will stand on that decision. We must surely get our freedom. No man born of a woman can deny us our freedom. You can't take it away from us. No matter what you do, no matter what you say, no matter your propaganda, your blackmail, you cannot take our freedom from us. We will be definitely free. Free from all your criminality, free from all your fraud, free from all your wickedness. We will be free. And we will celebrate once again in that land, the flow will make our home. Yes, we will celebrate in that land. No man born of a woman can stop that. The life we live today is not ours. We're not just living for ourselves, we're living for our generation and born. That is why we have to continue to do what we are doing, to fight until our freedom is signed and sealed. Today, it has become evidence that our freedom will surely come. Mazen Nandekan has spoken about it for a very long time. People never took him serious. Our spokesperson, Mazen Simon Ekwa, took over. And today, it has become something that you cannot be able to push aside. The evidence of our freedom is everywhere. The reality of Biafra is everywhere. And in days to come, by next week, you will see it much more clearer than ever. Next week, you will see it much more clearer than ever that the Biafrans are ready to go home. And it is not a crime to fight for your freedom. In fact, it is a right. It is a right for every human being to fight for their freedom when they feel oppressed. It is your right to ask for self-determination when you feel oppressed. And that is why we have decided to pursue that right. The Biafran people all over the world, more than 70 million people of Biafra today, have made up their mind and they have made their choice in the road, the path they will take. And the world is watching. The world is watching. They know that the zoo has ended. They are only waiting for the citizens to make the move, and then they will come in. They are waiting for the citizens to make the move, because if you don't make the move, nobody's going to come. If you don't make a move, you will only continue to legitimize that evil entity that is holding you bound. Until when you put up a fight. When you put up a fight, the international community is coming, and then now they will separate it. And that is what is about to happen. We are going to put up a fight. A formidable one at that. A formidable one. We will no longer be silent. We will no longer die in silence. We have waited for a very long time. And at this point in time, we have to take our freedom in our hand, fight like never before. The assurance is there that victory is at the door. There is light at the end. We have already started seeing the light already. The kind of support the Biafran struggle is getting today, the kind of support the Biafran struggle is getting today, it is not something you throw to the dustbin. No. It is not something anybody can wish away or throw away. No, you can't. The only thing you can do today is to join the struggle. If you cannot join, you stay away. Today, we are having fundraising today. We are raising funds for the ESN. If you know that genuinely you want to be free, be there. If you know that you genuinely want to be free, be there at that fundraising. Give your own widow's mite. Every kobo, every penny you donate matters. Our Supreme Ambassador Nankana made it. Donations is not needed from people in Biafra land. We know that people in Biafra land, they are facing challenges already. They are already facing the most difficult part. So those in diaspora, any place you are, join that fundraising today. Be in that fundraising and play your own part. It is very, very necessary. The ESN fundraising, the Liberation Army fundraising is going on today. Join the fundraising. It is no longer time for you to be saying you are doubting. At least if you don't know where your fund is going, when you follow up on what have been transpiring all these days, you will see the effort that our spokesperson, Master Simon Ekpa, is making. Great, great effort. And if you think it's easy, go and drag your own country, any country you are in and you think it's easy, go and approach the government of that country and tell them about Biafra. Go and make their journalists come to Biafra land and speak to Biafran people. Go and make sure that you begin to bring the case of Biafra to the front burner. In every country where you belong, those of you who are doubting, who are still opening their mouth to talk trash against Master Simon Ekpa, it is an assignment for you. If you think it's easy, you think that Master Simon doesn't do anything, just try. Try for the love that you said you have for Biafra. Those of you who are in Switzerland, those who are in Germany and so many other places, begin to approach the government of the country where you are. Go to their parliament, go to their government, go to their presidency, go to their media, drag interview to their media, drag their media, sponsor their media down to Biafra land to get facts. We are not telling you to push propaganda. Biafra, you don't have propaganda. Facts. Then come and get facts of what is happening in Biafra land, of the decision and the stand of the Biafran people. You know, the people we are dealing with have all the money. The corruption and the caliphate, they have all the money. They bribe all the media houses and they will continue to peddle lies. They will come and tell you that Master Simon Ekpa, nobody is listening to him. Master Simon Ekpa is not in the same line with Master Nandekano. Master Simon Ekpa is not a member of IPOB. Master Simon Ekpa is a Master Simon Ekpa. Lies. They try to feed themselves with the lie they believe in themselves. They tell themselves lies and they believe it. Meanwhile, the truth is obvious. If they can descend so low of forging a letter against Master Simon Ekpa, what would they do? They came on their platform and they are saying that Master Simon Ekpa is against Master Nandekano. That is not working for Master Nandekano. a disciple of Mazin Nandekan. Even while Mazin Nandekan was outside, he named himself a disciple. Mazin Nandekan never denied him. Up to tomorrow, he never denied him. And the man who has given them condition, if you want to do anything, if you want the narrative to change, bring Mazin Nandekan out. Bring him out. As soon as you bring him out, case closed, he takes over. But if you refuse to bring him out, that he will make sure that every single statement he has made will be carried out. And so it will be. There will be no political anything in Biafra land. You cannot conduct any political demonstration or whatever in Biafra land. You cannot. We are going to speak in our own political way. And the political way we are going to speak about is by sitting at home. That will be our own voice. Every one of us will sit at home. Just as our spokesman, Master Samanaka, have said, and he has given the date from 23 to 28. Biafrans have got the date and they have prepared. Because I can tell you, not only the Biafran, every single living being in that contraction is tired of what is going on. Every living being in that contraction, they are tired of what is going on and they don't want to be part of it anymore. They don't want to be part of it anymore. And when we say it, it is not just a made-up story. That is why sometimes we call on this media. If you think it's a made-up story, send down your media to that contraption. Let them go and interview the ordinary people. Don't go to the rich. Send your media to go and interview the ordinary people, those who these things are affecting directly. And they will tell you their stand, that they are tired in that contraption. They want to go home. And I tell you, we must go home. The time is that we must go home. No matter what you see, no matter the propaganda, the blackmail, no matter any angle they come from, whatever they try to push, we are definitely going to overcome. We shall overcome. And I tell you, you must stand firm. You must stand firm and listen to the voice of reason. Listen to our spokesperson, Master Simon Ekpa. Every single instruction he has given, I beg you in the name of Chukwu Okeke Abiam, for your own sake, listen to it. It is going to save your life. It is going to give you freedom. It is going to give you assurance. It's going to keep you safe. Every information you hear from every autopiloted platform, put it to your heart. Put it to use. Do not take it for a joke. Don't take it for granted. That is the way you can be able to survive the evil day that is coming. Our enemy is coming. The enemy that don't want you to be free, that enemy that want to make sure that you stay down, they are coming from all corners, from all angles, with all might. They are coming to make sure that they keep you down. Do you want to remain down? Are you going to allow them to continue to press you down? Will you allow them to continue to marginalize you, continue to dehumanize you, to continue to take your life, to continue to take the life of your loved ones? Will you continue to allow that? Do not. Do not allow yourself to be used. Do not allow yourself to be used. The same people that will tell you to disobey will be the same people to go after your life. Let me tell you, the autopiloted IPOB, under the spokesmanship of Master Simon Ekpa, on the lips of Master Nandekano, we are not interested in the life of people. Our desire is not to take any innocent life. Our desire is to save life, to protect life, to defend the life of Biafran friends and our visitors. That is our duty, to protect and defend our territories. The only visible enemy that we cannot spare is the terrorists, because they are coming to take off. That terrorist, some of them are in uniform. Some of them are in uniform. And they are in Biafra land, pretending to be in the military. But they are terrorists in uniform. And when you see their footprint and handprint, you will need to know. You don't need to be told. Only a terrorist go to the hands of the innocent and open fire without any provocation. Only a terrorist will go to the house of innocent people and set it ablaze with no provocation. Only a terrorist will go to an innocent person's house and bring it down without any provocation. That is the fingerprint of a terrorist. And these are the people we cannot spare if we come across them in Biafra land. We will not spare them. But if you're in Biafra land doing your legitimate job, if you're in Biafra land doing your legitimate job and obeying the laws and order of the land, I tell you, it doesn't matter your religion, it doesn't matter your tribe, it doesn't matter where you come from, you will be definitely, definitely protected. Biafrans protect visitors. Biafrans protect visitors and even love visitors more than themselves. They welcome visitors, they love visitors, appreciate visitors, respect visitors more than themselves. So whatever you see Biafrans doing today is to secure life and property. It is not out of wickedness. It is not to intimidate. It is not to overtake. It is not to run over. It is not to lord themselves over people. It is not to colonize anybody. It is to save the life of every indigenous person in that contraption. God has a reason for putting us in that place. And that reason for which he cleared the I believe, is to redeem that is what is obligated. And in extension, redeem Africa. It's going to be kicked off very soon. It will be kicked off very soon. So if you are in Biafra land, I urge you, please, pay attention. If you are here and you are not following Mazi Simon Ekpa on Twitter, please, after this program now, go to Twitter, look for Mazi Simon Ekpa. Look for Simon Ekpa on Twitter and follow him. If you are not following Mazi Simon Ekpa on Twitter, go to Twitter now, look for Mazi Simon Ekpa on Twitter and follow him after this program. Follow all the autopilot platform. Follow them. All the autopilot platform. Follow them so they can be able to get update on what is going on. Because we are entering into a very dangerous time. In that dangerous time, the only thing that will keep us safe and alive is what? Information. Information. Stay at alert at all time. Information. That is why you have to share this video as you join. Thank you, my beloved brother, Obiako Ofo. Thank you so much. That is what you need to do. Share the video. At least sharing this video is something. When you share this very broadcast, you are doing a job. You are doing something. Share it to your own WhatsApp group. Any group you belong, share it there. Family group, IPOB group, any group, share it. This information is important for every one of them, including those of them who claim they want Nigeria, so they can be seen. Some of them, you need to really push the word into their eyes before they can be able to see. We are not going to leave anybody behind, just as Mazi Nnamdi Kanu said. And that is why we see us shouting. Even at this moment, we are still talking. At this moment, we are still talking. The stage is set. You see, the enemy have fought their last battle. They fought their last battle when they begin to throw their propaganda at our spokesperson, Mazi Simon Ekpa, claiming that he was told to stop giving orders to Biafra. That was the claim of the zoo with their fake and fraudulent letter they brought out. The same way you see them forge that letter, that is how they forge certificate in every country. They fought every single one of them from A to Z, including presidency. You will see a lot of them who fought their certificates. Even people that don't have certificates, they are in the presidency. They rose to the rank of becoming the president. Many people today, you see them claiming to be professor, claiming to be doctor, PhD, this and that. All of them, fraudulent certificates. They paid their way to get to that stage. And that is why you see engineers that cannot produce anything. You see doctors that cannot work in the hospital. Doctors, they can't work in the hospital. They prefer to be a pastor. They prefer to be a motivational speaker. You see an engineer becoming a motivational speaker. They will go and become a pastor. Instead of opening a company, they open a church. That is what we see. Because of the fraud, most of them got their certificate in ill way. The politicians you have in Nigeria, most all the politicians, they forged their certificate in one time or another, except the ones they didn't catch. Some of them that went to the class to write exam, all of them, exam malpractice everywhere. They learn it from childhood and they transfer it to their children. They transfer, that is the same way they buy certificate for their children, they buy admission for their children. And this fraud continue to go over them. This is why you must end the contract record Nigeria. If you don't end it, they will be handing over the fraud from hand to hand, from one generation to the other. As Buhari is coming out, he has already bought certificate for all his children. After pushing them through buying a certificate and getting to the high level, before you know, they get a certificate and come on, they begin to claim leadership above you. They lord themselves over you. That fraud will never stop. The name itself is a fraud. Everything about it. So why must somebody who is saved begin to support that? That is why we Biafran say we are going home. And the time is now. I appreciate everybody that have joined me on this very broadcast, all the Biafrans all over the world, the Duduwa people, the Middle Betans. I say, may Chukwu Kukadu my God and protect you. Everyone that have participated in this very program, thank you so much for joining. Thank you for participating. May Chukwu Kukadu my God and protect our ESN, protect our army of liberation, protect all the armed group on the ground that are fighting for the freedom of Biafra, protect the Umuada. Protect the media warriors that are speaking on daily basis on behalf of Biafra. May Chukwu Kukabia Magara and protect our spokesperson, Master Simon Epa, wherever he is. We cover him with the presence of Chukwu Kukabia. And we ask that the grace of Chukwu Kukabia will continue to increase in his life and protect him. We bring Mazen Nandekano before Chukwu Kukabia for divine protection, for divine healing, for divine intervention. That Chukwu Kukabia will be with him, guide him, protect him, and bring him to us very, very soon. No weapon formed or fashioned against us shall prosper. No weapon formed or fashioned against Mazen Simon Epa shall prosper. No weapon formed or fashioned against Mazen Nandekano shall prosper. I appreciate every one of you that have connected to this program. Thank you so much for joining, and I will see you again tomorrow. Stay blessed and stay safe. Bye-bye.